Uploading data enables you to do data analysis, author visualizations, and enrich corporate data assets. In this video, you will learn how to upload Microsoft Excel and Delimited files, when to use the replace and append file options with new and updated data, and best practices when designing files for upload. When uploading Microsoft Excel files, keep the following in mind. You can use either Microsoft Excel or OpenOffice to prepare data. You cannot upload password-protected files, pivot tables, or crosstabs. Data filters are ignored, and if the workbook you are uploading has multiple tabs, each tab will become a table. Before uploading a file, it's a good practice to do a quick visual inspection. Look at the columns on the first row in the worksheet. These will become column headings in the uploaded file. You want to make sure they're descriptive. Everything following the first row will be uploaded as data. Check for subtotal and total rows and remove them to avoid double counting or misleading results. Also look for embedded heading rows and remove them too. And finally, check for blank rows in the data. A blank row identifies where the upload should end. There are three ways you can upload data: dragging and dropping a file anywhere on the home screen, selecting the open menu and upload files, or using the quick launch upload data. Let's use that method. Start by clicking upload data and then select the file that you want to upload and click open. A progress bar appears along the top and a message confirms that the upload completed successfully. To see where the file has been uploaded, I would go to My Content, which is under the Content folder. When you upload delimited files, you can use commas, tabs, semicolons, or pipes to separate columns. If your text contains a delimiter character, don't forget you need to use double quotes around the text fields. Your files can have CSV, text, tab, or TSV extensions. Using drag and drop, I drop the file on the canvas and the progress bar appears. A message confirms successful upload, and as before, the file's been uploaded to the default location in the My Content folder. The third type of file that can be uploaded is a compressed file containing any combination of Excel and delimited files. This lets you upload several files in one step. The compressed file can have either a zip or GZ file extension. One thing to note about using compressed files is uploads can take longer as each file is uploaded sequentially. With individual files, they are uploaded concurrently. Related data in the resulting tables is identified during the upload, something you do not get when uploading individual files. You may receive new or updated files to upload. In this example, the file contains all the students from the first upload. Data has been changed, a column has been added, and one student row has been deleted. Updating data always starts with a file. Selecting the action menu on the file to be updated, I see I have two options, replace file and append file. Because a column has been added, replace file must be used. This replaces the previously uploaded data. Selecting replace file, I navigate to where my updated file is, select it, and click open. The progress bar opens along the top, and I see the message that it's successfully completed. If a append file had been used, the updated rows would have been added to the existing data, resulting in duplicate rows. Append is intended for incremental uploads. When you're uploading data, keep these best practices in mind. The first time you upload a file, column names and data types are recorded as metadata and can't be changed in subsequent files. You cannot delete a column in a file once it's been uploaded. You can reorder columns in a file as long as the names stay the same. Avoid unnecessary storage and improve performance by removing rows and columns not used in queries. To improve performance, sort columns used by filters before uploading the file. And if you have large text columns in your data, remember each column cannot exceed 5,000 characters. Dates and times use the ISO standard 8061. Common formats are day-day, month-month, year-year, and hour-minute-second.
Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.